Meanwhile, the president has promised that key projects under the Presidential Infrastructure Fund, such as the Second Niger Bridge and the Lagos-Ibadan Expressway, will be completed before the end of his tenure. President Buhari made that promise in Abuja while taking stock of his administration's achievements. And Tai Amodu reports.
It is midterm into the second term of the Buhari administration and time to take stock of progress made in achieving its 9 key priorities. And amid worries about the spike in insecurity, the falling naira, economic uncertainty, and extensive external borrowing, this is a government which prides itself as making giant strides in infrastructure development. President Muhammadu Buhari believes his administration has grown the stock and quality of the nation's road, rail, air, and water transport infrastructure. He prides his government for establishing the Presidential Infrastructure Development Fund in 2020. With more than $1 billion in funding, and for advances made with the PIDF projects.
On transportation, we are growing the stock and quality of our road, rail, air, and water transport infrastructure. The Presidential Infrastructure Development Fund projects are also advancing remarkably. These include the 11.9-kilometer Second Niger Bridge, 120-kilometer Lagos-Ibadan Expressway, 375-kilometer Abuja-Kaduna-Zaria-Kano Expressway, and the East-West Road.
For his part, Vice President Yemi Osinbajo says President Buhari deserves the credit for providing steady leadership through the economic crisis of 2020. He urges more synergy between the Central Bank of Nigeria and MDAs, especially when it comes to the various interventions to beef up the economy.
So the Ministry of Industry, Trade and Investment should handle MSME interventions and those kinds of interventions. And we should know what the CBN is doing. In other words, if the CBN is going to intervene in the MSME sector, it should be with the full cooperation and consent or the Ministry of Industries. If they're going to intervene in agriculture, it should be with full consent. So that synergy is absolutely important. And as for the exchange rate, I think we need to move our rates to a more reflective market, as reflective of market as possible. This, in my own respectful view, is the only way to improve supply. We can't get new dollars into the system where the exchange rate is artificially low. And everyone knows by how much our reserves can grow.
Secretary to the Government of the Federation, Boss Mustafa, describes the last 2 years of the Buhari government as most productive. He discloses that the Federal Executive Council held 52 meetings, granted 579 approvals, comprising 381 contracts, 110 policies, with 878 contracts approved.
Key focus of this midterm ministerial retreat is to review the status of progress towards the delivery of 9 priority areas. This is intended to harness our collective contributions towards generating practicable solutions that will guarantee the level of impact we can be proud of by the end of our tenure.
The midterm retreat continues, and its aim is to deliberate on how to consolidate on the gains of the last 2 years. As the Buhari administration approaches its final 2-year stretch. Tai Amodu, TVC News, Abuja.